Okay, here we have a form with four inputs, and three are required or mandatory. Family name is required, and this is indicated with the keyboard star or asterisk, and aria-required equals true. Given name is not required, and it uses aria-required equals false. The street name is required, and this is indicated with the word mandatory, and also the HTML5 required attribute. And the suburb is required, indicated with the word mandatory, and the HTML5 attribute required, as well as aria-required equals true. Let's see how this reads with NVDA, and I'm using Firefox.
Heading level 1, identifying required inputs. Family name. Edit required has autocomplete. Given name. Edit has autocomplete. Street mandatory. Edit required has autocomplete invalid entry. Suburb mandatory. Edit required has autocomplete invalid entry. Button submit. Heading level to end of form.
I'm now going to go back to the top of the form using Shift H.
Identifying required inputs, heading level 1.
This time I will arrow through the form.
Family name. Edit required has autocomplete.
You might have noticed then that the keyboard star was not reported, but the aria-required attribute indicated that it was a required field.
Given name. Edit has autocomplete.
No mention of it being required.
Street mandatory. Edit required has autocomplete invalid entry.
In this case, the word mandatory is read with the label street, and also the required attribute is reported as required, and we get this strange mention of invalid entry.
Suburb mandatory. Edit required has autocomplete invalid entry.
And in this case, the word mandatory is read with the label suburb, and we hear that the input is required, and also we get the invalid entry comment.
Button submit. Heading level to end of form.
Let's go back to the top of the form.
Identifying required inputs, heading level 1.
I'm now going to tab through the form and fill it in.
Family name. Edit required has autocomplete. Blank. T-O-M. Given name. Edit has autocomplete. Blank. J-O-N-E-S. Street mandatory. Edit invalid entry required has autocomplete. Blank.
So we know it's required. And the word mandatory, we also know it's required from the input telling us it's mandatory. But it's also saying it's invalid entry.
C-O-O-K-R-R-D. Suburb mandatory. Edit invalid entry required has autocomplete. Blank.
Much the same as with street. The word mandatory is read with the suburb and the input tells us required and we're told it's an invalid entry.
N-E-W-T-O-N.
I'll tab back to the street and see what happens.
Street mandatory. Edit required has autocomplete. Selected Cook Road.
Okay, so it now makes it clear that it's Cook Road and we go down.
Suburb mandatory. Edit required has autocomplete. Selected Newtown.
So this form is reasonably easy to fill in. It's a little confusing when you read through the form or arrow through the form having these fields identified as being invalid. But when you fill them in, that invalid entry comment disappears.